Hi everybody, hope you are all fine. This is Atif. I welcome all of you to our YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Let us now discuss about the switched networks. So by using switched networks, we are going to understand how devices in a network communicate with each other by sending the data from one device to another device. So here I will be focusing on two types of switched networks methods. One is circuit switched networks. Another one is packet switch networks. So let us elaborate the differences between them with the help of a suitable diagrams now. So dear students, let me first concentrate on the circuit switch network, which is an old methodology, which is a traditional methodology, which is usually employed on telephone system. So that's why what I have taken here in my example to explain circuit switch networks, I have taken four telephones at the sender side and four telephones at the receiver side. Now here I want to establish communication among these 8 telephones now. 4 at the sender, 4 at the receiver. How this circuit switch network will work here, let us see now. Now there is one link which is kept between this sender and receiver telephones, and this link is not a normal link. This link is a high capacity link. High capacity link. And whatever the links you can see to the individual telephones connected to the switch, they are low capacity links. Low capacity links. Okay, sir, what is the difference between a high capacity link and a low capacity link? Dear students, high capacity link will transmit the data much higher compared to this low capacity links. For example, at a time, how many telephone pairs can communicate with each other in our example diagram here. We can see here T1, T2, T3, T4 are the 4 telephones at the sender side. T5, T6, T7, T8 are the 4 telephones at the receiver side. So at a time 4 pairs of telephones can communicate with each other without any problem. Yes or no? So which means this high capacity link can enable the communication of 4 pairs of telephones, which means 8 telephones can communicate without any problem. That is the size of this high capacity link compared to the low capacity link. Is it right? Now, for example, what is the role of switches here? What is the role of switch at the sender side? What is the role of switch at the receiver side? Let us say if telephone T1 want to communicate with the telephone T7 now. If a user is using T1 here at the sender, want to call a user who is at the receiving side, who will use the telephone T7. So in simple words, I want to establish communication between the telephone T1 at the sender side and at the receiver side telephone T7. Now how it will take place, let us see here. Now whenever a T1, first of all, the request from T1 will be sent to the switch. Now what this switch will do, it will transmit this request through a high capacity link. And through that high capacity link, it will go at the receiver side. There is one more switch. That switch will select the telephone T7 and it will pass the request to T7 so that T7 can lift the call. And in this way, T1 and T7, they will communicate with each other. Sir, like this, how many pairs of telephones can communicate at a time, sir? At a time, 4 pairs of telephones can communicate by using this high capacity link. So the purpose of switches in circuit switch network is to select the appropriate telephone at the receiver side and enable communication. That's what this circuit switch network will do here. Okay, now at present we are using computers. At present we are talking about how to establish communication among various types of electronic devices, which includes computers, smartphones, laptops. Now in these circumstances, packet switch networks is preferred here. So how packet switch network is used to establish communication, let us see this diagram now. Here also you can see here, instead of the telephones, I have taken here individual computers. These are the 4 computers at the sender side and these are the 4 computers or devices at the receiver side. And instead of switch, we are having here router. This router is mainly responsible to transmit the data here. Now, here also we are having similarly a high capacity link. This is a high capacity link and these are nothing but what you can see at the sender and receiver sides, they are low capacity links. Low capacity links. Now this time question, sir, what is the maximum capacity of this high capacity link? So the maximum capacity of this high capacity link is, at a time it can enable two computers to communicate with each other. It can enable only two devices to communicate with each other. One at the sender side, one is at the receiving side. Is it right? Now, okay, up to here also it is clear. Sir, we understood the work of router also. Router will send that required data to the receiving router, and receiving router will transmit the data to the respective device. It is normal. Now, what is the use of this queue, sir? Actually, that will be your question now. Now, in packet switch networks, there is one concept that is used here, that is known as store and forward approach. So our packets, the packets which are going to be transmitted, they will make use of this approach here in packet switch networks, store and forward approach. Okay, now let me give one small example now to illustrate the concept here about packet switch networks. Let us say computer A want to communicate with computer G. Computer A want to communicate with computer G. So first of all, the data in the form of packets, we know we are talking about packet switch networks. Here the data will be transmitted in the form of packets only. So A will send the required data in the form of packets to the router. Now router will see that the line is very free, high capacity link is free. So it will transmit the data to the router at the receiving side. Now this router at the receiving side will select that required computer, and the data will be passed to the computer G. Same thing happened from in reverse process also, from receiver to sender also. It is clear. Now, let us think that computer A and computer G are busy communicating with each other. This high capacity link is busy now. Now, in these circumstances, B also want to communicate with another computer E. So, this is second. B want to communicate with a computer E now. But the high capacity link is busy. Now, in this case, what our router will do, it will take these packets and it will store these packets in this queue. Here the packets will be placed here at the beginning. It will place that packet in the queue. Until up to what time it will place that packet in the queue? As long as the communication is busy, as long as the link is busy here. Once A's and G's communication is completed, once the high capacity link is free, then this packet which is in the queue, which is waiting in the queue, will be transmitted and it will be sent to the router. Okay, same thing happened from receiver side also. If one computer want to communicate with the computer at the sender side, if the high capacity link is busy, then it will be kept in the queue. So dear students, no matter how many computers are interested to establish communication, then what happened? Their respective packets will be placed in the queue. When the high capacity link will be free, then only the packets will be delivered to the required destination. That's why we are calling this method as store and forward approach. Store the packets when the channel link is busy. Okay, forward the packets when the high capacity link is free. This is how packet switch networks will work, and this is how our internet also works at present. So dear students, I believe that you people have got a clear picture about this switch networks, which is circuit switch network and packet switch networks. So any types of questions, you can simply put it in the comment section. So keep supporting our channel. So with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon, everybody. Take care. Allah Hafiz.